Okay, I just want to do a little video here about the 401 Winchester. And they might watch my live chats, they probably know that I'm hopefully getting one soon. So I was kind of like to make a short little video about the cartridge, read what Carts the World here says about it, and maybe talk about it a little bit. But I don't make this too long or anything, but just kind of maybe spur somebody's interest or anybody's actually interested in cartridge and stuff like that. There's not a whole lot on YouTube about any of the self-loading rifles or self-loading cartridges of the four that Winchester produced. Like, I think Log Cabin Looms has the most in-depth videos about like the 351 and the 1907 that there is on YouTube. Like, there's basically hardly anything. There's like one disassembly video, I think, for a 1907, and he just shows how to take it apart. He doesn't show you how to put it back together, which is kind of the part you usually struggle with. So. Like, thanks, you know. Or so we'll talk about the 401 here. I'll just read what Carts the World has to say about it. And historical notes. The 401 was introduced by Winchester in 1910 for the new Model 10 autoloading rifle, which was a minor modification of the Model 1907. Both the cartridge and the rifle were discontinued in 1936, but the ammunition was loaded by most ammunition companies until after World War II. It is another obsolete self-loading cartridge. In general comments. The 401 is the most powerful of the Winchester autoloading line, and it was the only one suitable for deer, which is debatable. I always thought the 351 was an adequate deer cartridge, you know, short range. It's a super long range or anything, but anyway. Just kind of weird how the people's opinion of what's a decent deer cartridge is like changed like quite a bit since this time period anyway, the 1910s, 20s, 30s. The 401 found favor with many hunters as a quick short range number for hunting deer and black bear. And actually when it was first came out, I think it was advertised as like stuff for like brown bear and even like moose and stuff at short range. But so sort of semi dangerous game, but as I said, like people don't view cartridges the same as they used to. Velocity is too low and the trajectory is too high for this to be a useful cartridge beyond about 150 yards. It can be reloaded, but all cartridges using semi-auto guns, it's necessary to stick to factory ballistics or the rifle may not function properly. Proper bullet diameter is 406, but 410 diameter. Revolver bullets can sometimes be used safely. Verify chamber clearance. With a bit of lathe work, 35 Remington cases can be converted to work perfectly in the 401 self-loading chambered rifles. But the easier cartridge to use now is actually 7.62-39 cases. Just sort of straighten them. And you have to modify the extractor groove here. It has quite a sort of a gradual bevel on the front. That's just so the rims don't get caught in the mag. Because if that's just a normal extractor groove, and the rim can get jammed into it, apparently. And I guess the shape of the extractor, when you make them up, sort of make sure if you can get an original case, I guess it would be helpful to help you to copy what the original type extractor groove was supposed to be like. But this is a pretty good, decent cartridge for deer and stuff. It shoots the factory loads were a 200 grain bullet at 2135 or a 250 grain bullet at 1870. So that's pretty decent. That's like, you know, 35 Remington ballistics, but it shoots like a 40 caliber bullet. So it's as I said, it's not really a long range cartridge, but you kind of see the shape of the bullets. They're quite blunt, so you can kind of imagine that they shed velocity pretty damn quick, because they got like the aerodynamics of a fucking brick. But anyways, just a little blurb about them. If anybody's interested in the other cartridges, I suppose I could do a video on those as well. I was doing that for a while. I was making up like a different cartridges and reading out of this book. So maybe if you're interested in that kind of thing, leave a comment what cartridge you would want, and then I'll maybe if more than one person maybe vote on it or something, and I'll go through and read that cartridge. Some of the stuff in this book is quite useful. Some of it's kind of dodgy, but I like this book. It's good for stuff like that. Good, decent information. And it was, a lot of it was his personal opinion on the cartridges, and he used some of these guns and cartridges and messed around with them and stuff in the old days, and Frank Barnes and stuff. But so he gave a little bit of opinion on what he thought was good and what was not so good and all this stuff. But so his opinion has held some weight, I guess. But so anyway, thanks for watching, guys, and give it a thumbs up or whatever you do now. 5 stars? No, that's 4 stars. Whatever the hell it used to be.